Hey Pixels, in this tutorial, you're going to learn how to design and prototype four drop-down menu components inspired by some of the most influential websites using the latest tools and features in Adobe XD. Remember, practice makes xopixel perfect. Huge shout out to ReadyMeg for partnering with me on today's video. ReadyMeg is a browser-based design tool that helps create websites, portfolios, online shops, and presentations without having to write a single line of code. It's like a graphics editor with enhanced capabilities for the web. You can design whatever you want with whatever layout you prefer and publish it online with one click. One other thing that sets ReadyMeg apart is its animation feature. You can easily animate any widget on your website, making it come to life on scroll, hover, load, or click. All of this is absolutely free. You can register without a credit card and publish up to one website at a time. If you're just starting out, check out their flexible set of templates. If you're not new to design, you might prefer a paid plan to explore all the tool's features. The promo code xopixel gives the first 100 users a 25% discount on their first purchase. First, let's set up our artboards. We'll need four 1280 by 800 pixel artboards with the following grid settings: 12 columns, 20 pixel gutter, 140 pixel margin. We'll also need to change the background color of the artboard to gray. That's all for the artboard setup. Before we get into the drop-down menu styles, we'll first need to design the navbar. Let's draw a white borderless rectangle that's 1280 by 80 pixels. We'll add a logo to the left-hand side, and then we'll add the navigation with menu links on the right. To design the navigation, we'll first design the Get Started button. Turn on the grid to make sure the button is aligned to the end of the grid. Draw a purple borderless rectangle that's 125 by 48 pixels. Then we'll add the Get Started label to the button, applying the button character style. Now, let's add the sign in menu link, applying the menu character style. Beside it, add a dividing line that's 48 pixels in height and coloring it a medium light gray. The final three menu links in the navbar are pricing, company, and product. We'll apply the menu character style to all. We've designed the navbar. Now, let's design the first drop-down menu style. The first drop-down menu style is a standard single-column drop-down, but we'll add icons beside each menu link to improve the user experience aesthetically and to help communicate each link's intent. First, we'll draw a white borderless rectangle with an 8-pixel corner radius. We'll use padding later on to even out the dimensions of the rectangle. Next, we'll write the first menu link, applying the menu character style. Below, we'll add a subtitle for the link. I'm using Lorem Ipsum, but I encourage you to tweak this to suit your user's needs. A I'll grab the first icon related to this menu link from the Components panel and place it beside the menu link and subtitle. With the text and icon selected, hit Command or Control R on the keyboard to turn on the repeat grid. We'll drag it out to create three more menu links. Now, we'll just need to update the text and icons accordingly. To complete this drop-down menu style, I'll group all the menu links. Then, I'll group the menu links with the white rectangle background. We'll turn on padding and set it to 24 pixels. This looks so good. The second drop-down style will have two columns, a menu and then an entire column dedicated to a call to action. Here, I'll show you how to design it. It's so easy. First, we'll need to grab a copy of the first drop-down style. Now, we'll click into the group to grab the white rectangle, and then we'll paste it outside of the group, placing it beside the menu and coloring it purple. We don't want the rounded corners in the center of the dropdown, so direct select the rectangles, hold down Option, and drag out the corner radius to 0. Now, we'll add some CTA text. We can also add an arrow icon to improve the clickability of the CTA, communicating to users that this is clickable and it's going somewhere. Finally, we can add a friendly illustration above the text. This looks good. The third drop-down menu style is full width relative to the grid container. You can't miss it. First, let's turn on the grid to help with alignment. Draw a white borderless rectangle that's 1000 by 226 pixels. We'll need to grab a copy of the menu links with icons. Arrange the menu links so that there's three columns with 64 pixels of padding in between. Place the links so that you can make room to place an illustration on the right-hand side of the dropdown. We'll need to duplicate some menu links. Look how nice this is. Okay, so this is our last drop-down menu style. We're going to design a wide drop-down menu once more, but this time we'll also design some big menu links. Draw a white borderless rectangle that's 892 by 262 pixels with an 8 pixel corner radius. Next, draw a light purple borderless rectangle that's 398 by 83 pixels with an 8 pixel border radius. We'll add a menu link and subtitle applying their respective character styles. Then let's place an illustration on the right-hand side. That's the first menu link. To create more links, we'll select the entire link, hit Command or Control R on the keyboard to turn on the repeat grid. We'll drag it out to create three more menu links with 32 pixels of padding. Once we have four links, we'll ungroup the grid and update the menu link label and illustration accordingly. Look at this drop-down menu, so stylish. So we designed all four drop-down menus and they look amazing. But we still need to do one more thing, prototype. But this time, we don't even need to go into prototype mode in XD. Here's how we can prototype the drop-down menu when we hover over the drop-down link. First, select the drop-down menu. We'll need to turn it into a component. Now, we'll hit the plus icon beside default state and add a hover state. With the hover state still selected, we'll need to cut and place the drop-down menu inside of the new component in its hover state. Now, we can see the drop-down link in its default state, no drop-down appearing, but then in its hover state, the drop-down appears. We'll repeat this for each drop-down menu style. Look at you designing trendy drop-down menu components. Well done. Stay tuned for the next tutorial because we're gonna code our drop-down menu with some HTML and CSS. I'll see you in the next tutorial.